So I'm bringing it to you. I promised you I would explain to you why it's so important to get on cryptocurrency exchanges now and not to wait. Even if you don't intend to buy any cryptocurrency, it's important for you to open an account on an exchange, 2, 3, or 4, so that if you ever change your mind and you see a hot ticket item that you want to get, you're ready and you're set up for it. So stick around, I'll explain why. Hey YouTube, it's your girl, The Real Teddy Talks, educating you every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday on entrepreneurship, your hustle and your grind, and building generational wealth. And today we're going to talk about getting yourself set up on cryptocurrency exchanges and why you need to do it. So I was chatting with my girlfriend and she's getting into the cryptocurrency thing. She's starting to like understand it. She's been watching my videos. She's learning about it. She's doing her own research. She's kind of getting excited. And she went to open, she used my link in the description box to open her Coinbase account where she gets $10 and I get $10 if she funds it with $100. And she was like, girl, why do they keep asking me to verify my identity? And I had to do this and I had to do that and I do this and I had to do it twice and I had to do it 3 times. And she was getting frustrated. And I told her, it's not you, it's them. Don't take it personal. There's this thing out there called KYC, know your customer. And there's a sub thing called AML, which is anti-money laundering. These two regulations that financial two institutions have to abide by in order to be trustworthy and be allowed to transact business as a financial institution, all right? So the KYC, know your customer. It's basically the first step is you're going to register on an exchange. We're gonna use Coinbase.com or Binance.us or Binance Regular. They're all really the same. Once you've done it on one, you can do it on all of them. First thing you're gonna do is create an account, your username, your email address, and they're gonna have you verify that. So they're gonna send you an email to make sure your email even exists, right? So that's the first step of the verification. Then you're gonna put your first name, last name, birth date, and address, all right? So those are just some of the things you're gonna ask for after you've already opened your account. And the reason you have to do this is just because your account's open don't mean you can do anything with it, all right? They're not gonna let you deposit any money in there. You may be able to transfer cryptocurrency from one exchange, another one that you have, to that one, but you're not gonna be able to deposit any money, and you may not even be able to buy cryptocurrency because you won't have anything in there to buy it with, all right? So there's levels of this identity verification, and you're going to have to go through this on every single exchange. There are no exceptions, all right? So the documents you will need to open an account on exchange is your first name and last name. You must know that, all right? You must know your address and it must be able to be verified. And certain exchanges don't allow certain country citizens of those countries to participate on them. For instance, I felt like I got screwed on Binance.com. I had a Binance.com when it first opened, like back in 2017. And I was banging out with my Binance, right? Making lots of money. And then all of a sudden they said no more support to US residents. And they kicked us off. And I waited to the very last minute when they were like, we will freeze your account and everything on it if you don't get off of our exchange. So I transferred from a Binance account to a Binance.us account very reluctantly. But I had to because whatever US regulations were, they are preventing us from having an account on this Binance exchange. I think there's a lot of politics involved, but yeah, they booted us off. Anyway, on these exchanges, you have to do that. First name, last name, email address, address. Then you're gonna have a next layer of verification, and that's going to be your ID, whether it's a state ID, your driver's license, or your passport. You will have to take a photocopy of this or a picture of those IDs, front and back of your IDs and the full data page on your passport if you choose to use that, and you will upload it into their system. So if giving this kind of information makes you kind of anxious and makes you kind of uncomfortable, you're gonna have to think about it because you will not have an account on exchange without doing this. You will not be able to do anything and transact business on an exchange without that layer. Then many of the other exchanges take it a whole nother step forward. That same ID that you just took a photocopy or a picture of front and back, you uploaded it to their website. They have it just like you asked for it. They may make you take a picture of yourself or a video of yourself holding that same ID and maybe saying some kind of phrase like, my name is so-and-so and I want to be a customer on your exchange, blah, 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 whatever it is, just to prove. So they have the physical evidence of the photocopy, then they have the digital evidence of you actually holding the picture with that photocopy. And this is to prevent all the scammers and the fraud that is plaguing the whole cryptocurrency system. There are a lot of layers. There's a lot of verification, and that goes, it gets sent to someone. There's a couple like Binance.us, they do the biometric scans of your face to make sure it matches your ID. I mean, it's so extra, but that should make you feel good because then you know that they're taking care and they're not just letting anybody on the exchange that could get on there and create fraudulent activity, hack the exchange itself, steal your money, or threaten it in any way. And once you've done all that, then you still wanna set up two-factor authentication, and that's gonna be on your like Microsoft Authenticator or Google Authenticator apps, so that anytime a transaction's made, you're notified, and before you can make any transaction, you have to put in that authentication code, et cetera, et cetera. So there are a lot of layers, and that's why I tell you to get started now. If this is something that you want to get on board with, and I believe wholeheartedly, 100%, this is something that you need to at least understand and know about so that you can make the decision if you want to do it or not. So don't let fear of getting involved, don't let complexity of the registering, getting on the exchanges, understanding cryptocurrency, understanding blockchain, misinformation when people talk about the black market and cryptocurrency used to buy drugs and buy people and sex slaves and all that. Don't let any of those things keep you from informing yourself and getting yourself educated on what it really is and the potential to make money. The longer you wait to get into this cryptocurrency game, the less money you can capitalize on. When I entered cryptocurrency back in 2017, there were hundreds of coins under 10 cents, under 15 cents, under a dollar. And it was, and those same coins now are $1, $3, $5, $300, $500, $2,500. Bitcoin over, well, now it's under 50,000, but it was sitting at over 50,000 for months. And I bought it at 1,000. Coins I bought at $8 and now worth $550. I mean, and that's a drastic swing, and that's because I got in early. So if you wait till the next bull cycle, which may be, you know, the bear cycle could hit any minute, or it could hit 6 months from now, and everything goes back down and stabilizes. Then we wait it out another year, year and a half, and we hit another bull run. The heights are gonna be higher than they were before, but they're gonna start off at a higher level. So the potential to make 100 times your money, 150 times your money, 20 times your money is going to be less and less and less. So I highly encourage you, get in now, get started, get learning about it, open your account on your exchange so you can get past the know your customer and anti-money laundering regulations so that you're ready. And when you feel ready, the system is set up for you already and you can start to buy cryptocurrency. That's my 2 cents. That's my tidbit for the day. Sign up for my cryptocurrency course in the description box and invest in yourself. Just 1% a day and reach your exponential greatness. This is The Real Teddy Talks, signing off.